Welcome to Tech Primers. In this video, we're going to see how to create Groovy tests in a Java project. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to show how to create a Groovy test class for a Java class. Okay, so let's take a typical example, right? So I'm going to create a small Maven project. Okay, and in that Maven project, I'm going to write a Java class and I'm going to show you how to write a Groovy test class for testing that Java class. So I'm going to testing, and I'll say Groovy example. Okay, my project name is Groovy hyphen example. I'll maximize this. Okay, so the dependencies I would need for this particular project is I need a dependency management. Let me import. Okay, I'll just directly do dependencies. So what all dependencies do I need? I need JUnit. So I'm just going to say JUnit. I'll just say I need 4.12. Okay, and also I need Groovy dependency. So I'm going to add Groovy all. Groovy hyphen all. Okay, so I'm going to add Groovy. I think Groovy version will be different. Let's go and quickly check that, right? 4.7. So let's use 2.4.7. So I'm going to use 2.4.7 of Groovy, right? So I'll just add build and I'm going to say plugins. Okay. And I'm going to add. So what I have done here is I've added the Groovy compiler plugin. Okay, into our project. I think this version, is it there? Groovy all. Let's check quickly why that is not coming in. So we have only 2.4.7 is there. And let's check. Yeah, org codos. Let's use 2.4. Yeah, it's there. Right, fine. Somehow it did not show in the previous. Okay, so let's let the dependencies get downloaded. Meanwhile, let's go ahead and create our project, right? So if you notice here, the test cases are showing Java. So I'm going to create a folder called Groovy. Okay, and I'm going to mark this as test as well, so that we can get this project to detect Groovy tests. Okay, also I'm gonna say cool. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna create a Java class called FizzBuzz. So if you know the game, right, FizzBuzz, if there is a number and if the number is divisible by 3, you have to say Fizz, and if the number is divisible by 5, you have to say Buzz. So it's a common game which kids used to play. So what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna write a class and implement that, right? Okay, I'm just going to say return me, what do I need to say, play, right? I need to play the game, right? So for that I'm going to say play and I'm going to return something. Let's say for now I'm going to return something. So I need to input a number, right? So if I give a number, this particular function needs to say what is it going to return, right? So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to just straight away implement it. I'm not going to do any TDD or something. You can check my other videos on TDD, how to do TDD. Okay, so I'll just directly implement what I need to do here. So I'm just saying if the number is divisible by 3, then return fizz, or else return buzz, or return fizz buzz. Okay, so that's what I'm going to do. So I'm going to say if the number is divisible by 3, I'm going to say fizz. If the number is divisible by 5, I'm going to say buzz. If the number is not divisible by either of them, I'm just going to say fizz buzz. Okay, so that is what I'm going to say. So I'm just going to write a simple class for this, a simple test class for it. Okay, I'm just going to say It's not showing me. It should show, yeah. So I am just saying create test. So I'm going to select here Groovy JUnit. Okay, so that it creates a Groovy test class. Now I'm just not going to do anything. I'm just going to say create. And now it's going to ask me where I should create, under Java or Groovy. So I'm going to select Groovy because it's a Groovy test case. And we can go ahead and delete the Java test directory. Okay, and if you notice here, the class got created. And also we have added JUnit. So what we can do is we can use all the JUnit functions or the annotations. So if you notice here, I'm going to use add test annotation. Okay. And I'm going to say public is not required basically in Groovy. And if you notice here, IntelliJ identified that should be fizz. So if you notice here, I can write methods like this in Groovy. So it's a string. So every method name is a string basically. So if you notice here, I can do something like this. I can do a single quote and I can start writing what is my description basically, right? So it is simple, right? If you are writing it in Java, you just say void should be fizz without any space, and it keeps on going. If there is a very big description, then the test keeps on growing, right? So in Groovy, you don't have to do that. You can do something like this, which is easy for us to understand. Okay. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to write a setup. So it's the same thing. You don't have to say public, but I'm just going to say setup. Right, and I don't have to use any private variable as such. So you can use definition, and there is no semicolon in Groovy, so you don't have to write semicolons. I can directly say, so here I don't have to define the fizz bus, but if I define, that will work as well. So I'll just show you both. So I'm just going to say new fizz bus. Okay, and I don't have to use any semicolon if you notice here. Okay, and I'm going to say fizzbus dot play, and I'm going to pass 1, right? And I'm going to say assert this equal to fizzbus. I'm just going to run this test case, but let's see, I made it this test case is fizz, right? So I need to make it 3, and then I will just say fizz, right? Let me run this test case. Okay, if you notice here, I just created an instance of the class using Groovy. So this is the Groovy definition for creating a variable. So you can say def if you don't know which data type it is. It is similar to JavaScript basically. So in JavaScript, you define a variable var, right? So it is something similar. So if you notice here, the test case is successful. Just to check if our test is really working, let's check this, right? I'm just going to make this test fail so that I can show you whether it is really testing our code or not. So this test should fail now. If you notice your test failed, and if you notice, Groovy is now giving you a clear notation saying, okay, I got fizzbus, but you returned fizz, which is not equal, right? That is what. Okay, let me run this. Cool. So now I'm gonna add few more tests to check bus, and also I need to check fizz bus, right? So I'll just add 5 fizz bus, right? And I'll run this test case. So if you notice here in Groovy, you can do whatever you can write in Java, but the only thing is you can write very minimal code. So you can start writing very less code. So I just need to do bus here. Okay, if you see, this is how you write tests in Groovy. This is a small test, so that is why we are not able to do lots of things. I'll show you one more additional example. So let's write some POJO, right? I'll write a POJO. What example can I take? Let's take a typical example of users. So I used to create users in every example, right? So let's create that. So this is just a plain old Java object. So I'm just going to create a typical users. I'm going to say ID. I'm going to say string name. going to say long salary. Right, in Java, what do we do? We need to create getters and setters, right? So I'm going to say getters and setters, right? I have created getters and setters. Now I need to create some constructors so that I can inject some values. Now if I need to write a test for this particular class, right? So I just say create test. I don't need these things. Okay. And I start writing Groovy test. Void should test users Pojo. Right. Now if you notice here, I can create new users, right? In Java, what do? We always, what do? We create an object and then you start using users dot set. So if I say this as users, right? You say users dot set ID and all those things, right? But in Groovy, you don't have to do that. You can directly assign variables like this. So for example, if you notice here, I can do this users dot name equal to tech primers, users dot salary equal to 90. Okay, so you can do this, or what you can do is you can do this as well. Since you have a constructor there, you can directly do this. You say one, you say name as tech primers, and also you can say salary as 90 year. That's it. So you can directly do this as well. So in Groovy, you don't have to worry about using the methods which are there in the Java class. So Groovy, as I said earlier in the previous videos, Groovy is using reflection to identify what are all the methods and variables which are there in a class. So you don't have to worry about creating getters or setters in Groovy. So you can directly do that. So if you want to print as well, you can directly use users.id. If you want to assign, you can do this. So it is like a, this is like a setter, and for a getter, you can directly say users.id. Okay. So that is why if you start writing tests in Groovy, it is very easier for you to write tests in Groovy, because you will write very minimal code. If you take a typical huge test cases, right, you will see the difference in the number of lines of code which you write inside that JUnit test. But in this particular example, there is nothing much for me to show, but if you take a typical huge project, you can see the difference. So that is how you can write tests in Groovy. So I'll just summarize what we did. So as a start, we added dependencies for the Groovy library. You can make the scope as test. I forgot to mention that you can make the scope as test, so that you can make sure you don't write Groovy test cases in the Groovy classes in the source code. Okay. So along with that, we have to add the Groovy compiler plugin, the Maven compiler plugin. So you need to add the Maven compiler plugin, and then you need to add the Groovy Eclipse compiler. So that is nothing but the compiler plugin for compiling your Groovy script. So whatever Groovy script we wrote, right, Groovy test we wrote, we need to have the compiler integrated into the Maven compiler. So that is why we had to add that plugin. Okay. And then I started writing Groovy test. So you can write whatever you can write inside Java. If you don't know any Groovy syntax, you can start writing it. So if you notice, your def is a way of creating variable names. So variable data type, basically. So you can assign any variable data type. So if you notice here, I have assigned the data type called fizzbus. And you can start asserting using the command called assert. And you can directly say equal to equal to. So this is similar to equals, because Groovy supports operator overloading. So basically, operator overloading is like, you can this equal to translates to a method called equals. Okay, if there is a plus equal to plus, it can translate to a method called plus, literally plus, plus, so something like that. So that is why Groovy supports operator overloading. So that is why we can directly use this instead of dot equals and stuff like that. Okay, so and also if you see, you if you want to access variables inside a particular object, you can directly access them. You don't have to worry about the methods of getters or setters. Okay, so that is another major advantage of Groovy. So there are lots of features of Groovy, but I just wanted to show you guys how to create a simple test of a Java class. So that is why I just created this video. So this particular code base, I will just push it to the GitHub repository. You can take it from GitHub. So I'll just put the link in the description below. You can take the project from the GitHub if you want to try it out. Okay, so that's it for this particular video. If you haven't subscribed to the channel, go ahead and subscribe to it. If you have, if you want me to do any specific video on any specific topic, just go ahead and comment in the comment section, so I can create that in the future videos. Okay, that's it for this video. I'll meet you again in the next video. Thank you.